Alright guys, so Fulu coming to you with another video. Shout out to the whole LDBC. If you like this video, please feel free to like it. And if you like the page, please feel free to subscribe to the page. It's always by choice, never by force. But anyhow, the Boxing Voice had a really interesting interview with Deontay Wilder in camp. And what I found interesting was is that what he was talking about Dillian White. So it appears that basically we all know Dillian White is guilty of doing this anyway. Dillian White, we know his pattern. His pattern is he calls these guys out, right? The elite guys. Not just the basic guys, but the elite guys. He calls the elite guys out. The opportunity to fight these elite guys are available. He just has to fight an eliminator. He doesn't want to fight the eliminator to fight these guys. And then what he does is he takes a lower guy to fight. And then he complains about that these elite fighters are ducking him. When all they are doing is just telling him that you have to earn your stripes and you can't just be fast-tracked to fighters. You know, there was a time where Dillian White, he could have fought Deontay Wilder if he got through Luis Ortiz. But what did Dillian White decide to do? He decided to fight Derek Chisora a second time. We fast forward. Dominique Brazil was willing to fight Dillian White for the eliminator. What does he do? I think he fought that guy, Oscar Rivas, I think. That's what he does. And so, we find ourselves really wondering, is this guy for real, or what is his angle? What is his end goal? What is he trying to do? And I think the reason why he feels the way he feels as of right now is because in that interview with the Boxing Voice, Deontay Wilder said that he smashed his girl when he was in the Klitschko camp with, you know, when he was sparring Klitschko. Deontay Wilder said he smashed Dillian White's girl. So I think that's why he's mad at Deontay Wilder because that happened. And here's the thing about it. If you're really mad at him, then you would do everything in your power to fight that man. And I just don't see it happening. I just don't see that kind of energy in you trying to push forward to make the fight happen. You know, at one time, he was, I believe he was talking to PBC. And literally, if you're talking to PBC, that means that fight's staring right in front of you. But you decline, you know, you decline to, you know, do even a couple of fights with PBC, you know? So with that being said, all I will say is this, on the Deontay Wilder's behalf, the real chances of Anthony Joshua fighting Deontay Wilder are next to none. They're slim to none. Okay? So, provided Deontay Wilder gets past Tyson Fury, which the majority of the boxing world thinks he will get past Tyson Fury, except for Mike Tyson's mark ass, you know, because Mike Tyson is just a jealous hater who can't stand to see a dude do better than him, and who can't stand to see a dude who's being more responsible with his money and not messing with booger sugar and doing all kinds of crap that would jeopardize his career. He's the only one that doesn't want to see Deontay Wilder win. And there's a couple of others, you know, these old timers who think that, you know, by him winning, it'll be a bad thing. You know, there's a couple of more. But the majority of us believe that Deontay Wilder will be successful, right? And so, with this being said, I think that the next logical step for him would be to fight Dillian White. Now, Dillian White doesn't really necessarily have the star power of a Tyson Fury, but I still think you can sell this fight in the United States because there's a backstory to it. But I believe this fight would be better in England because of the simple fact that Deontay Wilder would even add insult to injury even more, because it will mean that he beat quote-unquote one of their elite guys on their home turf. Yeah, I kind of, you know, although I don't think Dillian White is elite, I think he's trash. And he elbows a lot, headbutts a lot, holds your head down with forearms and crap like that. I really don't believe that he's an elite fighter. And I think Deontay Wilder will sleep him in a matter of, probably like the second round, he will sleep him. So, I think that it would be better for him to have the fight over there because there is a bigger fan base for Dillian White. And I don't know. I know that the Bronze Bomber has selling power by himself. You know, I get that part. But it's just, honestly, not really many people are checking for Dillian White over here. You know, nobody knows who that guy is. But I like the backstory that Deontay Wilder smashes his girl. Yeah, I can see why Deontay Wilder was able to smash his girl. I mean, Dillian White he's a cornball. He straight out let Barry Hearn's father say all that crap about slavery and stuff like that, and he just stood there and took it like a mute idiot. The fact that he still works for them after those comments shows you what kind of cloth he cut from. So, you know, I think that should be Deontay Wilder's next move. It's easy work. And then by doing that, he can add insult to injury. He would have had the audacity of not only smashing this girl, but also knocking him the hell out, which, I mean, I'm pretty sure he would. Dillian White would not pose a threat at all. He really would not pose a threat. And so, I think he should just entertain that fight next and knock him out, you know. And then, who knows what will happen next after that. Let's see who steps up to fight him next. But anyhow, man, that's all I got for now. We were signing out. Good job, man.